spirit, one God forever.
Amen.
In the gospel lesson that we just heard, Christ told Peter to get out of his boat and walk on the water toward him. This command brings to us an important question. When was the last time any of us stepped out of our boat? When was the last time we went out on a limb for something that we wanted? When was the last time that we walked in blind faith? We definitely do not do it as often as we should. Now, when it comes to something material that we want, I don't know how far out on the limb we should go, but it seems to be a greater motivation for some people. Certainly, there is always that temptation to go out on a limb for worldly things. Now, whether such actions are good all depends on the nature and the use of the object of desire. But when it comes to something for a godly purpose, we should go as far as we are possibly able to do so. If we really desire or need something, if we put our faith in God's providence, if we go out on the limb for Him, we will realize both earthly and heavenly blessings beyond our expectations. Now, there are those individuals, the majority of people, who like to comfortably sit in their boat because they have all that they need in life. They may want more, but they really don't need more. And they like it right where they are. If anything, they're satisfied being a casual Christian, but not an active, tireless, working member of the church. But the truth is that we can never do enough for the Lord and His church. And there are no limitations when it comes to service to Christ and to His church. I know most of you here today probably feel like, I think I've done enough, especially after this past week. But, you know, the disciples and the apostles never tired from working for the Lord and the building up of His church. And we need to help motivate others to have that type of desire and fortitude to do so likewise. Because putting our faith in action is truly a matter of spiritual necessity. It's also about being ready to step out into the stormy waves of life and trusting in the Lord. Unlike Peter in today's lesson, we should not allow the wind to deter us, or else we will sink as he did in that story. But to be sure, when the wind comes along, it will bring us down if we don't keep our sights set on Christ. You see, the wind represents anything that causes us to take our eyes off of Christ. There are a lot of things that can do this. What kind of things cause our eyes to float away from following the Lord? Well, surely the first thing that causes such distraction is money. Is also the lust for power and control. Material comforts, social recognition, even occupational obsession, people that are workaholics. And then of course, as we see all around us in society, there's alcohol, drugs, sensual passions, and just pure selfishness. These things very easily divert attention away from God. That is, from living life as He wants us to live, and from sacrificial, loving service to His holy church. To varying degrees, even those of us who are the most dedicated, we fall short of our full spiritual potential. But it's important that we don't ignore it as though we don't know, because we know. And it's important that we don't make excuses or excuses for others for these shortcomings. But we need to be ever mindful of what's really most important in life. We need to reassess any time we lose our direction. It takes a conscious effort to keep checking our life's compass, to see what direction we're really going in. This is absolutely necessary to avoid being distracted by the wind. If we do, the Lord will never allow us to sink. So it is that each day we need to take time aside for prayer and for contemplation. By doing so, we are able then to keep the Lord utmost in our mind as we go about our daily activities. Again, as we heard in today's gospel lesson, Peter was fine until he lost focus. He was scared by the wind. We cannot allow the wind to scare us, but to keep our focus on Christ, to take up our cross, and labor faithfully and tirelessly, and to pray, and to offer all the good works we are able for the Lord and for the building up of His holy church, trusting that in the end, He will save us. We ask this all in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God forever.